Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us for this filmmaker chat, part of the New York Asian Film Festival 20th edition, presented by the New York Asian Film Foundation and Film at Lincoln Center, and running from August 6th until 22nd. I'm Karen Severance, one of the festival programmers, and our interpreter today is Joanna Lee. All of us are thrilled to return to in-person screenings this year, and those of you who are lucky enough to be in New York City will have a chance to see the breathtakingly beautiful film Anima on the big screen at Lincoln Center's Walter Reed Theater. Anima is a film with a romance at its heart and an environmental message in its soul, as it highlights the mystical life-sustaining bond between humans and nature that once existed, while also depicting what our rejection of those bonds has brought. The film has been nominated for the New York Asian Film Festival Uncaged Award for Best Feature Film this year, and I'm really pleased to have with us today the Anima director, Cao Jinling, joining us from Beijing. Welcome to New York, Director Cao.
欢迎曹金莲导演。谢谢谢谢，很高兴我们的影片能够入围，然后我也特别开心我们的片子今年能够跟纽约的观众来分享。
Thank you. I'm very happy that actually my film is selected and also that there is the opportunity to interact and to share with the New York audience.
Yes, we just wish that you were here with us.
我们当然只希望呢，最好是你可以在纽约跟我们在一起。啊，是，我当然是非常期待的。I really wanted that too.
Yes, maybe next year, maybe next year. So, because this is going on, this COVID situation, I know that Anima has already appeared at several other prestigious film festivals. I'm wondering if you had a chance to go to those festivals and present your film in person.
因为现在全球的疫情，所以呢，知道呢，这个电影其实在其他的各大的国际电影节已经演过了。就想问一问导演，其实到现在有没有机会到其他的国家参加这些电影节？
我还真的有，我们片子是在开罗国际电影节进行的世界首映，也是我们的片子第一次面对观众。然后是去年的12月，我印象很深，我们真的是排除万难，然后和我的制片人奥斯卡，然后还有我们的一位演员，饰演图图的演员，我们当时去了开罗。 当时我们有打最开始的那颗疫苗，然后回去了之后，其实我们当时都没有买到回来的票，因为前后的飞机全部都熔断了。然后因为我是内蒙古人嘛，我们就说，哎呀，回不来怎么办？我们说那我们就像我们小时候在内蒙草原上放羊一样，然后我们开始去放骆驼，那我们也要去，<笑>我们去了一次。OK。
There only has been one occasion in which we actually managed to attend, but it was very important. It was the Cairo International Film Festival. It was the world premiere, the first ever time that Anima actually was shown to the public. And actually, can you imagine, that was actually in December of 2020. You can imagine the problems and the difficulties, but guess what? We made it. I was there, also producer Oscar, as well as the actor who played Tutu, the older brother. And, you know, I'm from Inner Mongolia, you can imagine. So we just went through a lot to get there. And actually, just so you know, we actually at that point when we arrived, didn't even have a return ticket because the flights were completely canceled. Everything was topsy-turvy. And then we are from Inner Mongolia. So what we said is that, okay, we will do what we did if we were young in those old good old days in Inner Mongolia. We would just basically herd, maybe not sheep, but camels. We'd just do whatever we can. This is it, we made it.
But you did get to take an airplane home, correct?
到最后其实可以坐到飞机回到中国吧。
对对对，隔离了很久。<laughs>
Yes, we did, but after a very long quarantine.
Ah, yes. Well, let's talk about the subject at hand, which is your beautiful film. Anima is an incredibly assured feature debut. I mean, of course, I know that you have started your career as a screenwriter, and you both wrote and directed this film, but the story is so incredibly unique. While it seems to be about these two brothers and their rivalry over a very resourceful young widow, it's also about the death of their traditional way of life, and in a larger sense, about how activities like the clear cutting of their forest is leading to the death of our planet. So tell us how you arrived at this wonderful combination of this romance and family story, as well as urgent environmental message.
但是呢，也是关于传统生活方式的消失，还有呢，更宏观来看呢，就是砍伐森林使到地球的很大的一个危机，所以呢，就想知道你是怎么构思构想这个爱情、家庭，也是关于环境信息的一个故事。
这是一个特别好的问题，我是因为从小出生长在这片森林里边，所以说现在在我们电影里呈现的很多的人物，对于我来说，其实他就像我的家人一样，已经陪伴我很多年。 我最开始想做这样的一部电影的时候，是因为我想写一个天地人神之间的故事，因为就像我们的英文名字，我当时想了很久很久，然后我们最后定了是 Animal 这个名字，就是因为它在我们的影片里面，我们呈现的这个鄂温克族，他们最早的这个宗教萨满教，其实它的教义只有四个字，就是万物有灵，就是 Animal 的意思。
Okay, so basically the idea is that I grew up in that whole area. I grew up in the forest. So these are people, these are the environment that I'm actually very used to. Now, the thing is, you know that the story is actually about the Evenki minority that actually, that's very specific people in that area. And the thing is, they are shamanistic. And so the shamanistic is actually about, the heaven, earth, or the sky, the earth, man, as well as spirit. So the idea is that I really wanted to capture that, and because that is actually the mainstay of what I wanted to express. 继续吧。
然后呢，就是我们其实探讨的还是人跟自然之间的关系，但是我并不只想说在我的影片里就是去传导啊，我们不应该砍树啊，这个树我们应该去植树，我们应该，我是这样子，我是很偏社会性的传达，所以说我们是想，所以在写剧本的时候，我就很想放在一个，怎么说，一个宇宙观的格局上。 就是讲天地人，他们之间该是有一种什么样子的关系？我们中国古典的这个道家文学讲的，我们做什么事情成功要天时地利人和嘛。那后面还有一个神助，然后还有一个格局。那格呢讲的就是前面四个之间的这样的关系。所以说我是想有一个这样大的。 这种宇宙观的统辖，然后我们再去讲一个人他一生，他我们的主人公林子其实他有一点点人神之间的感觉，因为他是从我们原来有一句台词，就是他的爸爸是一棵树，他的妈妈是鹿，他是来自于天地之间的孤儿，那他去以人的身体去感受所有的人之间的兄弟情、爱情、父子情，然后包括他跟万物，他跟树之间，他跟这个动物。 之间种种的这种关系的连接，通过他的一辈子的故事来去传达我想传达的那个内在意义。
So there is the universalist theme, and that the whole universal theme actually has a lot to do with the Taoist thought. And the Taoist thought has to do with that relation between man, between heaven, and between earth. And you remember that actually our main character, also the thing is, I didn't want to actually have a story just about, you know, environment without a story of people. And at the same time, I actually wanted to be a, you know, a social commentary, a story that is actually about a society. Now, in this story, Linzi, who is the younger brother, and it's an interesting thing. He's an orphan that he was somehow taken by a couple. Now, the thing is, this Linzi, the name itself already has this idea of the combination of nature and human. And at the same time, there was actually a line, a dialogue in the film that actually wasn't used, but the idea is that the father of Linzi is the tree, the mother is actually a reindeer. And so that type of thing, well, it wasn't there, but regardless, the idea is that we wanted to trace that entire life of somebody. And then something very important about the urban Kur is that actually their philosophy is that everything, every matter, everything has a spirit. And that spirit has to be honored.
Wonderful, wonderful. And without knowing the backstory about the tree and the reindeer, you do sense with Linzi that something is really different about him. I mean, you know, he's a man who constantly works to protect the trees when his brother has embraced the easy riches of cutting them down. And he's also, in a way, refusing to embrace the modern world. He wants to stay true to the sacred spirits around him and his traditions of his ancestors.
Okay, 所以现在再问一问呢，就是林子，其实你已经看得到了，他这个人物呢跟其他人不一样。 他的哥哥呢，当然是为了赚钱了，已经看不了。但是他不愿意，他一定要保留着这个森林，保留着树木，保留着大自然，保留着这个传统的生活方式。就想知道呢，其实呢，这个人物的构思啊是怎么样的？ I'm asking specifically the character, the making of that character of Linzi.
Yes.
因为我从开始设计我们的主人公的时候，他其实有一点反类型，他不是我们传统，就从编剧上考虑，他并不是我们传统的一个英雄的人物，他走了一个什么样英雄的旅程，他就是他要去保护这些树，但是我们并没有给他成为英雄的机会，他最后也没有保护下这个树，这就是其实这是我看到的事实，然后我也想说，就是我们没有必要说我们为了让 最后有一个happy ending这样子的一个，我们更多的其实是希望大家在里面更多的能够看到自己，看到反思，就是每个人的心里面都会有一个要保护的森林，但是可能有没有去实施，有没有保护下来，我们想是把这个问题最后留下来抛给大家，所以暂时这样的写作，从剧本上来说，我的监制和我的 主创演员都跟我说会有一点点冒险，我也不知道观众会不会喜欢。对。Okay,
so the character is very unusual in the sense that you realize that he does not end up as a hero. So it is not any sort of tip, not an archetype in any way. Okay, because in the end, he failed. He actually tried to protect, but he did not manage to do it. Now, the question is that as I was developing the script and even working with our producers and the rest of the cast, I mean, we realized that this choice of not making him a hero is in itself a risk. And we're wondering, you know, how the audience respond to this, because in the end, it was actually a failed attempt in protecting the forests.
We will have to wait until after the audience has seen the film, but I hope you get a chance to hear directly from audiences about that. For me, as a woman, I have to say that the real hero I felt was this wonderful, fierce female warrior, Chun, who's played by the brilliant Qi Shi. And you know, in a sense, you've written this character as a kind of role reversal. She's the one who traps Linze at the very beginning. Then she gives him medical aid. She rescues him from a storm. She goes out to, you know, to track down his brother. She's doing all of the things that we would expect of a typical male character. Did you have any inspiration for this character, Jun?
我希望观众呢看完这个电影以后呢也有他们的反应然后可以跟你聊啊跟你沟通的现在这个问题是关于剧中的女主角春这个角色呢我觉得是很强大的一个女人很强的女人呢女强人而齐溪呢这位女演员也把她做得很好很好所以我心想问一问其实这个角色这个女的角色呢是一个很 不典型的女人啊，一是她设下一个陷阱，把林子抓起来的，而当林子有那个受伤以后呢，也是她帮她疗伤，在一个大风暴里面呢，也是我们的春救了这个男人的，还有呢，到最后呢，又找她的徒徒，这个她的兄兄，但是也是同一个问题，也是那个女的去把徒徒找过来，所以想问一问，这个角色是有一个什么一个想法，或者什么一个启示，或者是什么启发你，构造这个角色？
我们在剧中呢是我们的林子是被一个鄂温克族收养，鄂温克呢他又细分为是始鲁鄂温克，那他们是一直生活在森林里的，就是住在那样子的搓骡子里边的，他们现在在中国只有209人，他们是最后的母系氏族，就是他们。 他们这个很小的这个民族里面有四大家族都是女人当家，然后他们的酋长都是女人，所以说我们现在留下来的最后的一位女酋长，她已经102岁了，她也是我们这个电影的民俗顾问，然后我们这里面的封葬啊，有很多的这种仪式啊，都是从那儿来，她还给我唱歌，就他们在河边 的那个歌也是他唱的，所以说，而且他在我们影片里面会讲说这个树叫什么名字，长到3岁叫什么名字，都是他告诉我的。所以说，我又读了他们民族的很多的书，然后又采访了很多的这个民俗学的教授，所以我们是有很多方面的这样的一个想法，然后又根据我自己的对于剧情上的这样的需要，把它塑造出来。还有一点就是。 春也不单单是一个女性的角色，她有一点点像是森林母亲的另外的一种的现身的一种化身，是一个非常浪漫主义的一种代表。
Okay, so two things. It's very important. You know that this story is actually based on the Ōwenkā. Of the Ōwenkā race, of the peoples, they are also subgroups, as you can imagine. And one such subgroup is actually a matriarchal society. And FYI, of that matriarchal society of that group, we only have currently 209 surviving members. And you can imagine, so that's how amazing it was. And of that is actually basically four major families, four clans of 209. And actually, I'm very happy to tell you that actually one of the big advisors on the Ōwenkā tradition and cultures is actually one such female leaders of the tribe. And she is actually 102 years old. She's the person who sang the song by the river. She's the person who actually was able to name the trees for me. And all of these sky burial, all of these various rituals are things that actually I learned from her, as well as from the research that I did of all sorts of ethnographic studies.
Yes, the film is very, it has a foundation of ethnography, which gives it, you know, a much more, it's so deep because we understand, okay, this is a group of people that we haven't probably seen on film before, and you bring us into their lives, you draw us into their world so wonderfully from the very first moment when the camera glides across the trees in the forest. And I want to talk about that camera. Of course, one of the first things that all of us at New York Asian Film Festival were so impressed by was the photography in the film. You have extraordinary locations, of course. You also have a really gifted director of photography, Mark Li Pingbing. I wonder if you could talk a little about your relationship, your collaboration with him on the film, and about some of your challenges as you were shooting the film.
要跟你说呢，是最重要的是谢谢，因为呢，其实这个故事是关于恩恩科他们民族，我们其实从一开始就已经看得到、学得到、知道里面的民族学的基础是那么扎实的，还有是呢，有机会呢，真的可以认识他们里面的生活。我们知道呢，是我们平常在美国、在全世界没有机会可以直接看到的。 好了，现在呢就要问一问呢，是关于摄影这个电影里面呢，一开始的摄影，你看得到森林，你看得到天空，你看得到树木，就已经觉得是完全被这个大自然好像呢拥抱在里面了。好了，知道呢，当然是李平斌，很有名的一位电影的摄影师。
就想问一问你跟他的合作是怎么样呢？还有是呢，有一些什么大的挑战吧，在拍这个电影。嗯，是。那我们先说，就是我跟李平斌老师，跟斌哥之间是怎么合作上的？是因为我们之前我编剧的一个电影叫《七十七天》，然后在西藏拍摄的时候，我有过去探班，然后当时我就跟斌哥讲，我说。 我要做导演，我要拍一个森林里的片子，天地人神，然后呢有大洪水，有大风暴，又有很多熊，然后人熊之战，然后我就尽可能的去描述。然后当时，斌哥就跟我说，我说到时候我拍的时候你能不能来给我拍？他说好啊。后来他跟我讲，他说他答应我的时候，他觉得根本就拍不成，<笑>就觉得我。 就觉得我一个女孩子啊，然后在一个原始森林里面拍这么多的东西，怎么可能？我又从来没拍过。然后过了2年，我就找到他说：“我说有人给我投资了，然后演员是谁？咱们拍吧。”你答应我了，他说：“哦，是吗？”他说：“那我答应你，我一定会来。”是这样的。
Okay, so basically, I've done scripts, and so there was a film that I was involved in, called 77 Days, and then Evenki was involved, and the filming was actually in Tibet. And so I was there as they were doing the production and all that, and then I was very excited to meet Mark, and then, well, I call him Brother Bin, as in Mark Li Pingbing. I basically said, you know, I have this idea, I have this film. When I make this film, I want to make sure that you will be my, you know, the cinematographer. And the reason is that I described everything to him. I said, you know, there's going to be nature, there's going to be huge floods, there'll be huge forests, there'll be sky, there'll be wood, there'll be people, there'll be everything. And basically Mark said, yes, I'll do it. 2 years later, after I've managed to actually, you know, basically, you know, have the production team and the cast and everything ready, I told Mark, Mark, you promised me 2 years ago when I met you that you would be the cinematographer. Now I'm making the film. And Mark said, actually, 2 years ago, when I agreed to do that, I thought that you, a woman, young woman director, would never be able to do that. So I just said yes. But now that you've actually made this a possibility and made this reality, I will be your cinematographer.
Wonderful.
然后第二个还要说一个。 就是我们在拍摄的时候，其实要拍一个人的一生，因为莫尔道嘎的森林在中国也是独有的，所以说我们要拍三次，就是相当于是在一年当中，我们要春天去一次，夏秋去一次，冬天要去一次，那对于大家来说都是非常大的挑战，因为就几乎这一年就不能接别的电影。 然后我们第一次拍摄的时候是冬天，是零下40多度。因为斌哥常年住在洛杉矶，然后他的家乡在台湾，就都是很热的地方。 方，然后要去零下四十度，而且他从来没去过。所以说，而且在我们拍摄的这四十多天里面，就冬天的四十多天里面，大多数都是室外的。我们在室外一待就待十几个小时，所有的衣服都打透了。他当时这样的年纪，然后他亲自去织机，手后来回到美国的时候都是有一点点冻伤 和这种筋骨，所以我特别特别感谢斌哥。然后从对于我是新导演，但对于我的帮助，然后什么事情跟我商量，然后说我原来想象的森林是什么样子，因为我一直想，我说我想拍一个森林的散文诗，然后一直去帮我去实现，我特别特别感恩。
Well, because you can imagine this is a film about an person's entire life. Also, it is really about the life of a forest. So actually we had to film it three times because we need to capture all the different seasons. And so we did winter, and then there is spring, and then also summer, autumn. Now, we started the first phase of the shooting actually during winter. And we are talking about 40 something days of sub-zero temperature, actually apparently minus 40. So it is very, very cold. And you have to understand that Mark Li Pingping is actually, you know, he lives in Los Angeles. It's a warm place. And also he's from Taiwan, another warm place. And so spending that time, and also remember that every day when we were shooting, we are talking about, you know, 10, 12 hours outdoors. And Mark was very dedicated. He actually was the person often actually holding the camera. I mean, there's just a lot of that. And so you can imagine that apparently going back to LA, you know, there his hand was you know, in trouble, had to be treated because of, you can imagine the exposure to the cold. So for that, I am very, very, very grateful to Mark Li Pingping.
I'm afraid we've run out of time today. I wish we could continue talking for at least as long as the film is long, 2 hours. Wonderful film. It feels like you're covering almost a century of this wonderful family's life and the life of the forest as well. It's such a wonderful film. I want to thank you so much again for joining us today, for taking time to talk with us about your extraordinary film. And I want to thank also our virtual viewers who are perhaps watching this before they see the film. If you have not seen the film and you still have time to do so, remember that Anima will be screening at Lincoln Center's Walter Reed Theater on August 8th. At 6:30 p.m. To find ticket information and everything else you need, please go to this address, nyaff.org online. And remember that the New York Asian Film Festival is running from August 6th through 22nd. Once again, thank you so much, Director Cao, and of course, Joanna Lee for interpreting. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hope to see you in New York next time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Bye-bye. Yeah.